Loving another requires a conscious decision to relate to the other at all levels of one's being. It is not a sight or sound reaction, but a purposeful act to gain access to the inner resources of spirit that empowers, enriches, and enlivens. Would you please let the people in? Let us take a time to still our minds as we seek to shut out all the emotions, all the issues that we came into this place with, and come to reside in the presence, knowing that there's only one power, one presence, the source of all good, God the good, omnipotent. You may close your eyes if you choose to, but come to a place of rest. Of myself, I recognize that I can do nothing. I recognize that everything that is done through the Spirit of God in me. So I quiet my will so that the will of Spirit can do its thing in and through me. I just relax. I just surrender and into a place of contentment, for I know that I know that I only have one source, one supply, and that is God. I know that the nature of God is absolute good. So therefore, whatever is supplied is absolute good. And I say thank you. Thank you for the rain. Thank you for the air. Thank you for the food. Thank you for the friends. Thank you for family. Thank you for everything that moves through my mind, that I experience in my body. I thank you. I thank you for the abundance of all good things. Thank you for the wisdom, the understanding, for the health, for the strength, for of myself, I know nothing and can do nothing. I just surrender. I stop complaining and start appreciating how wonderful you are to me. Without asking I wake up in the morning, the beauty of the sun, the chill of the air, whatever you supply me with, I know is absolute good. So I relax. I still my mind. And I enjoy. For whatever comes to me, there's an answer to every problem. And everything that I have need of, thou hast placed before me. I am not afraid, for I live in you, and you are in me, and we are one. And I rest. I just abide in this presence, that you're knowing that your power is now working in and through me. I am grateful. And I just say thank you. And so it is.
We have a musical selection. Skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? They're really saying, babies cry, I'll watch them grow, they'll know much more than I'll ever know, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. And I think to myself, what a wonderful
good morning again.
Good morning.
The lesson will be given by me. My name is Evan. Life is a journey between two points, birth and what we call death. And all we have is the in-between called a life. And yet still, some of us don't live because we don't appreciate now. Our minds are either set in the past or in the future. We're either planning or remembering. And all that energy eats up the quality of life that can happen now. Some of us, for religious reasons, are planning for the great beyond. When I get there, there will be milk and honey. And some, looking at the past, don't know what milk and honey is. So even when they get there, they will not be able to appreciate it. Now is the time. Now is living. We live now. We don't live yesterday. We don't live tomorrow. To bring quality to our lives, we got to begin to see others as we see ourselves. We got to begin to engage and not push people away, but to meet and greet and interact. Because when you realize it, every human being on the planet Earth, each one is made up of three components: energy or spirit, a body, and a mind. The spirit keeps moving and changing and growing and expanding. And the body, cells are dying and new cells are being born. But for most, the mind remains static. The more static the mind is the less happy or contented you can be. After a while, a static mind squeezes in on its own self, bringing unhappiness, sickness, and premature death. A lot of people believe that dying has to do with your body. The first death is in the mind. When we refuse to use the power of life and the power of love to engage each other so that we could bring forth a world of peace so that we can have joy. All conflict in families, at work, in nations begin when each one of us hold that what we believe is right and the only right that there can be. When we refuse to interact with people from a position of growth and development and taking in the new, we punish ourselves and we live in hell. Deepak Chopra says in his book, we must learn to see the world in ourselves. When we see the world in ourselves, there are no more outward obstacles to happiness. There is no more blame. We can start claiming. We don't look to fight with outside people or objects or things or anything like that. We realize that as within, so without. The inner and the outer worlds are mirrors of each other. What I see outside of me comes from the image that I have in my mind. And I program that so much that it's reflected in the people and the world around me. Miserable people attract miserable people. Happy people have around them happy people. We and the world are one. There's no difference between your world. And you know, when I say the world, I mean your experiences. Your experiences are no different to your inner core. What you hold to be true will manifest itself as reality in your life. Changes, they change according to your level of thinking. If you change your thinking, you can change the quality of life, change your world, and change your experiences. If you are vibrating out of a level of fear, you attract things in your life that are fearful, scary. But when you operate out of love, you get to realize that all of us are bringing good. And we stop interpreting things according to our consciousness and start accepting people, respecting people, and appreciating people, because we know that all of us at the depth of our soul are one, and we all require the same amount of love for ourselves and for others to be happy. Is that right? Can you relate to that? If you can't, you can buy the book. Read the book. Okay? So when you start to operate out of love, love in its right term means oneness without separation. When I start operating out of love, I don't see a distance between you and I. I begin to respect and accept you. We can get closer together, and then we can share. And there is no fight, no tension, because I respect that you are different. Different in every area of your life. I always think about, you know, my two sisters and I when we were growing up. Our same mother and father. We ate the same food. Drank the same water. We slept in separate beds, but we bred the same air, and we were different, and we fought, because why? Our thoughts about ourselves and about each other were different. What I'm saying this morning, the only difference between you and I are our thoughts. Thoughts are based on either a foundation of love or fear. Most of us are products of our environment. We have been taught things that we have come to believe to be true about ourselves and about others. Some of us walk around very insecure, without worth or value. But that's mental, it can change, trust me. I was there. When you walk around not knowing your power and your worth, you feel worthless. And therefore you attract worthless people in your life, just like you. And then we want to chase the people away, but more keep coming back. Because we become the power of attraction. When you are not happy, have you ever noticed your friends are not happy? Those are the ones you go to and complain to, and they could agree. Oh, yes. Yes, I agree. We talk about Janet, and they say, yeah, Janet is the way I see you see it too. Because we're not happy. It says that like attracts like. So if you're in a relationship that you don't like, I think it has nothing to do with the other person. It has to do with me. So if changes must come, I must be willing to make the change within me so that the change would flow out of me and begin to attract the kind of people that I would like in my life. J. Krishnamurti says, in one self lies the whole world. And this is very important to realize that everything that is in the universe is in you. That you are a microcosm of the big one. That everything in the universe contains the same dynamic energy that flows, whether it's in Jupiter or wherever it is, flows in you. You are made of the same stuff that everything in the universe is made of. And if you know how to look and learn, the door is open and the key is in your hand. Within you, within your hands, lie the key to health, to strength, to wisdom, to understanding. You see, some of us are waiting for somebody to come again to help us figure out life. You have the keys within your hand to unlock the doors of separation and find love in everything. Because wherever you are, the same principle God is there. And if God is love, I've got to be love. And you got to be love also. Is that right? If you have any problems with what I'm saying, put your hand up and Janet will talk to you after service. Matthew 19 and 19 says, love your neighbor as yourself. This is a very tricky statement. Because right now, you are loving your neighbor as yourself. In other words, if you don't like what you have and you want to change it, you've got to change the way you love. Love is about empathy. Instead of criticizing someone, realize that you too have made mistakes. That wherever any other person may have gone, you could eventually go there. So when you see the man in the street, don't pity him. Empathize. You see, empathy and pity are two different things. Pity is condescending. Empathy is feeling equal to. And you have to know that whatever has happened to any other person on the planet Earth could happen to you. I have seen the mighty fallen. And I have seen the lowly rise. We do not know what tomorrow will bring forth. That's why we try to live healthy, happy, and prosperous lives. When? Today. Our focus must be on today, not on tomorrow, because with all our planning, I have seen plans crumble in the midst of developing the plans. Loving kindness, to love someone with kindness, is to feel yourself moving from you to that other person, all of you being transferred. Whatever you love about yourself, you transfer to the other person, and it's reciprocated. You can feel the flow. When Jesus was touched by the woman who had an issue of blood, he said, I can feel virtue go out of me. Have you ever felt true love go out of you? You can answer. Please do. Have you ever touched someone, not physically, but be in the presence of someone and feel totally connected? And you could feel the energy that they have flowing through you as yours flow through them. This is what love really means. To be at oneness with. No condemnation, no separation. This is a total walking side by side and not saying a thing, but still connected. You see, we feel we need to talk to say I'm connected with you. That's why we use the internet. We have Facebook. And we are still afraid to come close to somebody and touch them. But we could touch them on Facebook because they're not there. When we meet each other, we must bring to the table as we sit down to participate in a meal of information with each other. We've got to come with respect. I have to realize that you and I are one. Set aside my differences and see you as the universe sees you. You know, the universe doesn't know who you are and what you are. You are just a dot in the universe. You are the one who may be claiming who you are, but the universe does not know that about you. You are just a cell within a cell within a cell within a cell. Infinite cells all around you, just like a body. Every cell in the body, trillions of cells in the body, each one is functioning according to its consciousness, just like you. One thing you have to realize, you are important to the universe. Every cell is important to the body. And if you could understand that about yourself, you can respect the importance that you have in the universe. Don't sell yourself short. And don't give away your power just because you don't like yourself. You start loving yourself for who you are. In spite of what people may say about you, you are all that God is wherever you are, just like everybody else. And you need to celebrate that and honor yourself. Respect yourself. Don't do things that you will happen to regret after. Everything that you do the best that you can wherever you are because you respect yourself. Isn't that nice? Do you respect yourself? I am now learning to, as I'm talking to you. Sometimes I forget and I go back. And I have to bring myself forward again and say, Evan, you can't do that. I can't eat that junk. You know, I've got to eat right. I've got to exercise. I've got to do things to help build me up because I respect myself so much. Another quality that we have to develop as we come to the table with others is honesty. Are you honest? No, none of us are. But I'm trying. Every step I make, I hope to be honest. But I come with integrity, knowing myself, and I want to do better. And the reason why I'm telling you that none of us are really honest, have you ever taken a pencil home from work? a piece of paper, a paper clip, an elastic band. It's not yours. Simple little things like that. But we would like to be honest. So honesty calls for practice. When I realize that I am doing something that is not consistent with the nature of oneness, I stop doing it. But tomorrow I might do it again. So I don't condemn myself tomorrow for doing it. I correct myself and I say, look, I hope I don't do it. I don't make promises and say I will never do it. Because you ever made a promise and say, I will never do that. And when you do it, your heart starts to boop, boop, boop. You want to kill yourself for it? No, don't kill yourself. As a human being, you will make mistakes. Honor your mistakes. Claim them and say, I've made a mistake. And I hope that I can do better the next time. Respect yourself. Use honesty as a mark to come to. Don't pretend. Always come with integrity. Another word is acceptance. For some reason, I have met beautiful people who think that they're ugly because they have a little mole on their cheek. They refuse to accept that they are perfect, whole, complete. It doesn't matter when they go in the mirror what they look like. To be perfect, whole, and complete means to be the way it is. You are the way it is because that's the way it is. Accept that. Don't spend millions of dollars on trying to fix your face. Accept your face. It's your face. You got to live with it. So suppose mascara doesn't make anything else, you will not look good. I'll look good wherever I am. You may not think so, but that's your business. Because you are working on some different criteria other than myself. Once I'm alive, I look good. Hello now? No, I didn't hear anybody doubt me, so it's true. I gotta learn to accept myself. Before I could accept you in my household, I have to accept myself. If I am living a life of pretentiousness, then how could I be whole? Huh? When I keep judging myself, and putting myself lesser than I really am. I do crazy things. I go out of whack. Have you ever been out of whack? Have you ever done crazy things? Man, when I was a teenager, I did some crazy things. And sometimes when I look back, I say, that couldn't be me. But it was me. Because I didn't know who I was. And I did not accept me for who I was. I wanted to be somebody else. When you accept yourself for someone else, other than somebody else, you start telling yourself, I love myself the way I am, and I don't really need to change. If I need to change, I hope to get better than I am, to find approval in my own self, and not look for anybody on the outside to say how good I look or how good I am for me, than to say I'm looking good. I know I have a body that whatever I put on would look good. Because I know it's not the clothing, it's what is coming from within me. And nothing that you say will go make me go home to change. Another word that is very important as we come to the table is understanding. Understanding comes through knowing. Knowing comes through practice. When I come to know who I am, there's some things about me I come to know. There is no other human being on the planet Earth like me. Wow. That means I am unique. Different. Important. Special. No one else is like me. When I know that, I can stand before anybody and not be ashamed. Because I understand. I understand that. So I don't worship you. I don't put you on a pedestal. If anybody is going on the pedestal, I'm going up there. If you don't look at the pedestal, that is your business. But I'm going to have mirrors all around me looking at me on the pedestal. When you get to understand who and what you are, your life will change. You stop doing things for people to like you. You ever invited people to like you? And you make all your changes and you cut your arm off and clip your nose. Hello now. And you're gone with your eyebrows and they got tilted because they like it, and then they leave you. And you got to spend time to bring that back down. Go look for the arm that was cut off. No. Be yourself for you. And understand that. They can say whatever they want. Once you know who you are, you can go through life with a smile and be contented. The other one is to have compassion. Compassion is a big one. When you know that life, in terms of the existence of the universe, is just a blink of an eye, why waste time to make yourself better than other people? Why not see through all the stuff that happens in our lives? That we are all the same, and put some energy into other people. Don't look down on them. Don't curse them. See through the pain that you have experienced, their pain, and have compassion. They know not what they do. You know, sometimes all of us have come from a part in the journey that we have experienced a lot of stuff. And when we get over the stuff we have experienced, we look long at people who are going through that same stuff. Lend a hand. Brother, sister, cousin, friend, this is what I did to help me get through this. I'm not telling you you have to follow me, but I'm here to lend a hand. If you need a hand to get out of wherever you are, use mine. Don't walk away from situations with disgust. Walk away knowing that you have placed yourself in it and help someone. Compassion. When you come to the table, come with composure. You come knowing that no one on the outside could make you get angry no matter what they do. Wow, isn't that wonderful? To be able to walk into a situation and there's a storm outside of you and you can just be at peace. It will not bother you. Learning to hold your composure. Don't let people see that they have power over you. Let it pass. Don't believe that you have to change the world to be like you. No. Accept the world for what it is. It is what it is. If you want to act silly, as in my statement of being what silly is, you be yourself. But who you are will not disturb me or make me get angry and upset. Have you ever left home in the morning looking good? Feeling good? Hello, have you ever done that? Yes. You jump in your car, and the first car you met, somebody who's driving that car did something, and you start to swear at the car.
No. Peace. Be still. Let them go. You know, every time you get angry, your heart rate goes up. You know that, right? Your breathing changes. That means every organ in your body is participating in your death. You're trying to kill yourself. And all your organs are saying, I will help you. This is what you want. I'll give you more. So the first car, the second car. You ever been like that? The first car does something and the second one does something similar. And you're still mad. And you get to work mad. And somebody who used to say good morning to you passed by and you didn't hear it and you're mad with them too. And the phone rings because it was 5 minutes too and you usually get there after that and the phone and you had and you're mad too. And you stay mad the whole day. You left home happy. And what happened? You allow the actions, the words, and the reactions of others to create a storm in your life. Has that ever happened to you? Can you relate my story to your story? Why? Why do we need to allow people to change our peace? Jesus said, blessed are the peacemakers because they will find peace. Peace begins with me. And a fight begins with me. Have you ever followed the first driver to his workplace? Have you? No. You ain't reached there yet. But it's coming. If you continue being charged with anger as soon as somebody does something, you will get there. And you will move to California. And you will buy a gun. And it will be called road rage. And then you'll be brought up for murder. Leave them alone. Love them. Send love. I love you. I love you. When you operate from love, you find joy in simple things. Joy comes very quickly. Not joy clap. Joy. An emotion of feeling good and happy and bubbly. When last have you felt bubbly? Hello, hello, hello. I know Janet is feeling bubbly because today she's celebrating her birthday and she has all her family and friends with her, and I know she's feeling bubbly. Are you feeling bubbly? Are you feeling light? When you're joyful, you feel light. There's no stress. This vein does not stick out. This does not pulsate. Every part of your body becomes numb. Wouldn't that be nice? To live in a state of numbness? No, you'll be called a numb nut. But to have peace that flows like a river. Wherever you go, you can smile and let things be without trying to disturb the peace of others. Love, not fear, not separation, is what the universe is built on. We look at all the planets held in the same place, and they don't complain because Mars is getting more light than me. It is what it is. When we begin to live in a state of it is what it is. You are you, and I am me.
We shall not meet in mind, but wherever we are, there will be peace because there's understanding and there's respect, there's acceptance, there's compassion, and there is total acceptance in all that we do. God bless you. God keep you.
There's a place in your heart, and I know that it is love. And this place could be much brighter than tomorrow. And if we really try, you'll find there's no need to cry. And this place, you'll feel there's no hurt or sorrow. There are ways to get there. Dread.